for a while with Mo himself in the Riviera in southern France. How is the Riviera, Mo? How is it treating you?
Actually, it is slightly better than London. I had a tough week last week in London. We're working on this.
I see.
But I've come for a 48-hour short break here.
I see.
Here I am working with you. You're making me work, Shaka.
Oh, it's a pleasure, of course, always working with you, Mo. Now, we talk about making some exceptions. You have actually broken the rules already. You made some exceptions and awarded an honorary award to the Madiba himself, former South African President Nelson Mandela. Why did you do that? And you can't do it for Jerry Rawlings or for Kenneth Kaunda of Zambia?
Exception is an exception. Otherwise, it become a rule. We think Madiba is really probably the father of good governance in Africa. And I think probably every single person in Africa and outside Africa will agree to this statement.
Mm-hmm.
This is an amazingly wonderful man, wonderful human being, and a great leader who happened to be there at some historical moment and managed to steer really South Africa forward over a very difficult period. And we could not fail really to recognize his role, and that's why we offered him this exceptional honorary award.
I see. Now, Mo, I'm sure you've run into a lot of people who have been asking you, why did you decide, frankly, to award African presidents, give them a lot of money, perhaps something they don't need, and in fact giving them money or rewarding them for something that they are expected to do?
Right, that's a very good question. Let's start with this expected them to do. We are all expected to do our jobs. But Shaka, when you do extremely well, I think you get a bonus from Voice of America, or you get a promotion.
Well,
People get gold medals, you know, people get the Nobel Prize for doing what they're supposed to do. You know, you are a chemist, you are a physicist, you are a mathematician, you are a very well-paid professor or senior person, you are Secretary General of the United Nations, paid, you are Director of the Atomic Energy, well-paid, still you get the Nobel Prize and you get the money. So the recognition of excellence is always there, and all what we're doing here, don't forget, we publish the index every year. We take a very hard look at Africa, and and I hope your readers go and look at the index, which we launched actually the same morning, on Monday morning, for this year, together with the announcement of the winner. And we rank, we evaluate performance of each governance. We really are outspoken about all what's going on in Africa. And that also needs to be balanced by recognizing excellence when it happens, because Africa is not a terrible place, and we have good leaders. Shaka, when I go to conferences in Europe here, and I ask the audience, did you hear that? How many of you heard about Mugabe? And everybody raised their hand. How many heard about Bashir? Everybody raised their hand.
Yes.
How many people heard about Darfur? How many heard about Somalia? Then you ask, how many heard about President Barreas or Festus Buhai?
Yes.
Two or three people raise their hands. One of them inevitably is the ambassador. And that is unacceptable, because the focus of the media on the two or three travel spots in Africa present a negative view of Africa. Africa has winners. Africa has wonderful countries which came out of poverty. We need to honor these countries and those leaders. That is a very important thing to do.
What goes on in your mind more when you hear some of your friends on the continent, for example, Ugandan President Yoweri Museveni, saying, for example, that he really does not need your award because he is not a poor man?
I think people somehow look at the award as a financial gift or which it is, but there is something much more important than that, which is honor. Which is honor. When the president here, he's been honored by us Africans, honored by the whole world. I mean, Chissano now was telling me, he was in Monday with us in London during the announcement, and telling me, you know, whenever I go lecturing, because he's done a lot of lecturing all over the world, actually, it is interesting now, I've always introduced Paris as the winner of the prize before they mentioned that I was a president or I come from Mozambique or anywhere else. That become, you know, it is the honor people getting out of this appointment. And that's much more important than the money. As for the money, the winners, invariably, as it happened, and if you check, you'll find all those winners left office with no money. Because those are very clean people. They left with no money. And instead of them now going looking for work, or like our people, our leaders in Europe or US or whatever, who always have the boards of the big banks and big funds and big companies orbit for them, our leaders have no such potential. And what we want is to say, you have done a wonderful job, thank you very much, don't worry about going finding a job, earning money. We will give you here a good financial support. Now, we want you to continue to work. Those guys don't go to swimming pool, Shaka. Those guys work. Chissano have been running from Uganda to Madagascar to DRC to Kenya, fighting for peace and reconciliation, trying to solve the continent problem. Mukai has been working on AIDS, has been working on rights of women, he's been working climate change, which affected Africa with Ban Ki-moon. He's one of the eminent persons group appointed by Ban Ki-moon. Those guys are working and lecturing, going, telling our kids in the schools, what does it mean to be a president, how they did it. And that is very important role. They don't need to have to go and get a job, but they can go and do some more important work.
I'm afraid, my friend Mo Ibrahim, time happens not to be our best ally. I would like to take this opportunity to thank you so much for taking some time to join us.
And regards to your guests, I didn't have a chance to talk to them, but thank you very much, and good evening.